Commissioner, thank you so much for joining us. We're here at the Southern Nevada Health District. A meeting just concluded, and something that was on the boards on your plate here is the declaration of an outbreak of acute hepatitis A in Clark County, about 50 cases so far in the first half of the year. These numbers are up.
Yeah, and so we want to be out in front and preventative for the long term. We know that it has a lot to do with our homeless, on the way that they have sanitary conditions for them to eat food and take a bath and, you know, wash their hands every time. So we're looking at different ways that we can collaborate with other community partners to ensure that we can get as many hepatitis shots out there in our valley for the long term. So we do about 1,500 a month, but we probably need to do about 2,000.
So obviously many of those homeless are probably not coming down here to get the shots. How do you get those out into the community to the people that need them?
So what we've done in the past is when they have come through the jails, we were able to give them those shots right then while they were there. We've gone out along Main Street. We've given them in those cases. And so today I was asking if we should even reach out another step and go to our substance abuse partners and see if we can make sure that they get them right when they walk in.
Commissioner, largest population that contract hepatitis A is are the homeless population, and the county has done made a number of steps this spring and this summer already to help the homeless. Let's talk a little bit about some of the money that has been dedicated for marijuana licensing fees, about $12 million that eventually will be dedicated towards homeless assistance. Talk a little bit about that.
So I'm super excited. So we put together a plan in January, and we get regular updates from staff every month on where we are on creating beds and services. And beds, we know, are the number one priority. We have to give them a clean, healthy place to sleep, and then we have to move them into long-term housing overall. So we have been adding beds. We just added 784 2 weeks ago, and we're only at about half of the money expended that we had anticipated to begin with, and we're over two-thirds of our way of our first goal. So it's pretty exciting. We're getting people off the streets, we're getting families into stable environments so their kids can get a good education. We're putting all of the wraparound services around those homeless folks so that we can give them everything that they need all at once for case management to help them be successful.
And the program, or the system, I guess you're trying to do, is rapid rehousing. Explain what that is.
So really is to get them off of the streets into a clean environment so that we can assess them, so that then we can figure out what is the best case scenario for them moving forward. And what we've done in the past is we've had partners that were 3 days in and then they put you right back on the streets. We want to get them in, take as much time as we need so that we can get them in a long-term solution so that they can be successful.
Commissioner, a couple times a year there are community-wide census of homeless population taken, 6,000 earlier this year, 5,200 now. Are you satisfied? Well, I mean, satisfied may obviously isn't the right word, but this is an improvement, I suppose.
So it is an improvement, and so we hope to have even more of an improvement by the next census in January. And with us adding over 700 beds in just 5 months, and we have really had some community partners come to the table and they want to be part of the solution, so they're offering up different housing options, that really will help us make a huge dent. Homelessness will never go away 100%, but we will make a big dent and at least be able to give them the services they need.
Recently, there was a fairly historic meeting where the Board of County Commissioners met with the Clark County School District's Board of Trustees, and there were a couple items on the table that emanated from the legislature's Senate Bill 543 and Assembly Bill 309, basically to streamline or improve and take a look at the K-12 education system, possibly with a 0.25% sales tax. Distill this a little bit for us.
So it was a historic meeting. I think it was the first time that was ever done, but it needed to be done. So traditionally, Clark County is not in the education business, nor do we necessarily want to be in the education business. But the legislature afforded us an opportunity to look at things that are not bound by the Constitution, which is their job. And so we're really looking at pre-K, we're looking at truancy, absenteeism, adult ed, to see if there's a way, and many of those people come through our social service department, so that's why I feel it's appropriate that we have a joint conversation, because if they're not in school, they're probably in our social service department. If they're not working, they probably need assistance from social services. So if we can collaborate, work across the community to put together a plan that makes sense, but I think for the general public, they want to see where their money's going. And I don't blame them. I agree with them. For years, we've been putting money to education, and it never seems to be enough. But if we can really dial down and say, here's what you get, as we did with homeless, I think that there could be some support to track that for the long term.
And is it now that the county kind of has a seat at the table as far as helping implement some of these solutions possibly for the school district, or what's going to happen next, I guess, Commissioner?
So let me give you an example. So currently, 2 weeks before school ended, we got 2,500 education neglect. That means that students were out of school more than 21 days. 2 weeks before the end of the year, there's not much that we can do, but we are bound by law as a county to address that issue. So we want to be rather on the front end, so when they've missed 3 or 4 days, so that we can find out what's really going on at the home and make sure that they're still in that home. And so I think from now, we're looking at different avenues on what makes sense, kind of a blueprint of what voters could expect if we did implement it. But we're a little bit out from that. So we'll see what happens in the next 20 to 30 days.
Something that much of the discussion focused on was the Open Schools, Open Doors program getting reactivated. This is something obviously that the county wants.
So we've had a lot of pushback from folks that think that we're gonna open the school 24/7, you can walk in the front doors and people can do whatever they want. And that's not it at all. What we're looking for is opportunity to have organized events, organized play, and having a place for the kids after school. If they want to be on a t-ball league, they have a place to play. If they want to play on the playground while their parents are at another game, but just a place for us to be able to come together as a community and have those neighborhood schools. And so we've had, and I don't disagree that we shouldn't pay part of the maintenance, because absolutely we should, but it's not what people think, 24/7, free rampant pay, we should, but it's more of organized. So we have areas across the valley, and in my district especially, where we have no parks, we have no green space, we have no basketball gyms, so why couldn't we go into a school and have free play with our parks folks supervising it? So I think that there's a good potential that we'll see something for 360 schools being available. That saves Clark County from trying to find $40 million to build a community center. It saves the district, it shows a true partnership, and kids end up owning the school in their neighborhood.
And this is hardly novel. This is something that had been in place but was gone away, I assume, for monetary reasons?
Yes, so for about 15 years ago, when we all went through the downturn, it was hard for everybody. Everybody had to cut back, including us on our own staff, but now we need to collaborate and get those areas back open, because neither one of us can build fast enough, but we know that playing is healthy for families, for children, and we want to get back to having that collaboration.
And finally, Commissioner, I know you are very much a NACO supporter, and the 3,000 NACO people descended on Clark County recently to show off our county and to strategize with other county folks. Talk a little bit about how this convention went.
So it went really well. So we had 3,000 elected officials from around the country, and really this is a time when we come together and talk about federal strategies. How do we work together federally to ensure that counties are getting the most dollars that are available? But two, it's sharing ideas so that people can take it back to their community. So one thing that we learned 2 years ago from a NACO convention was how unconnected many of our communities are right here in the valley. And so that became a NACO initiative. So across the country, people were all looking on, ensuring that everybody had access. So in Clark County, we now put fiber in all the roads because we learned that some folks in the center of town had no internet access, no Wi-Fi. So we showed them our human trafficking component, which is phenomenal, our harbor program. We showed them behind the neon, you know, what really goes on. We're a big community. It was pretty eye-opening for them. They were they had no idea. They thought we were just the Strip. And we reminded them the Strip is very important to how we live as a community, but outside of that, we have a lot going on all the time.
And NACO also recognized us for our Pathway to Poverty and the Las Vegas Resiliency Center.
Yes, so we received 4 achievement awards for different social services that we used. And so what happens is that becomes a blueprint for other communities that may want to put it in place on smaller levels or a bigger level. So that's exciting that we're recognized for some of the things that we do.
Thank you very much, Commissioner.
Thank you. Appreciate it.